Hello, everyone. Welcome back to From the Hip. I am here today with Charlie Tutch. How are you, Charlie?
I'm very happy to be here.
And now, Charlie, you are a Pilates instructor, and I will be honest, I have not done Pilates before. How did you get into Pilates?
Well, Pilates came to me, and I started to get requests for doing Pilates from members of my community, members of my gym, and they had all different needs, whether it was flexibility or strength or parts that were stiff. Or a lot of times these days you have a lot of clinicians that are recommending Pilates for people with back complaints or, you know, joint injuries. It seems to be sort of a post-rehab thing. So I love the fact that people like you come to me with no previous Pilates experience, because a lot of what I do has to be born sort of organically. There aren't a lot of classic type Pilates exercises that you're ever going to see me teach to my students.
Is that right?
Yes. In fact, I taught a class the other day, and some of the students who had never taken my class before walked out and said, "Hey, you didn't do that hundreds. You didn't do the rolling like the ball. Why didn't you?" And I said, "Well, I have to look at my audience, and
right.
I have to see, are these exercises going to benefit them? Are they going to be productive to them? Is it going to make them stand up better? Are they going to leave feeling taller? Are they going to leave feeling, you know, wheel greased and super glued back together?" And sometimes I have to edit the content of those movements and give them maybe the step down, the progression that'll get them there. Like, I'm the gateway drug
right.
to some of these sexier moves, because you have to start from somewhere and people have to know that they have the tools to get there. So
what I'm hearing from you is, when you teach a class, not everyone is taught the same way.
Absolutely.
Everyone
not.
Has a different experience, a different need and my hat is off to you, because you really have to be very intuitive that way to see where people are maybe struggling, or their wants and their needs, and really adjust the program for them. Am I correct in saying
well,
that?
Well, I would love to think that I am intuitive, but I think that might be giving me more credit than I'm due.
I think you're too.
I happen to be very, you know, I'm a people person. So when people come into the room, I don't just let them line up on a mat and get down on the floor and start going.
Right.
I try to chat it up with them. In fact, every class I teach, I encourage my students, "So what's going on with you today? What do we got to do?"
Right.
You know, I tell them, like, "You know, I came in totally unprepared today. Will you tell me what it is I'm going to teach? Because I really don't know." And everybody's always got a little something going on.
Right.
And so the thing is, even though we're all different, we're all the same. Compression is, we are, you know, working against gravity every day.
Yes.
So I don't know what world you live in, but gravity is affecting us all. So most of the injuries that I see, most of the compromise that students come in with, scoliosis, stenosis, herniations, bulgings, plantar fasciitis, whatever it is, unpacking everybody, decompressing everybody, works for everybody. And there's a way to do it that I can give to you and to the person next to you and to the person next to you that makes sense in your body.
Right.
You know, I always say, I'm going to give you 10 different options, bite off the pieces you can chew, and leave the rest behind.
That's good.
Right? I lay it out like an a la carte menu. Take
right.
the parts you like and skip the rest.
Right.
Because there's going to be another opportunity to come back for more.